Say anything. I wanted you to hear the introduction of that song. I don't know. I don't know where this is going to go today. Sometimes I just like turning the camera on and I just start talking. Whatever comes out, comes out. Seems like lately, that's all I had to talk to is the camera. Kids are going to school, Debbie's going to work, dog don't talk back to me. I wish he did, but he doesn't. Although he does follow me around everywhere. Anyway, quick note here, this might be a two-parter. Because I get going and all of a sudden I'm over 10 minutes. And the one I made yesterday was over 10 minutes. I had to cut some out and it kind of lost its movement. But anyway, I got thinking about this circle of life thing. I don't know. It puzzles me at times. I don't know what circle of life's got to do with what I'm about to say, but you can twist and turn it, spin it any way you want. But, Debbie and I basically met 10 years ago, 2000. And most of you that know me a long time saw that relationship come along, and it had some trying times to it. Mostly it was me wanting to push her away because I didn't want anybody in my circle, I had this wall built up around me, and I had been on my own for so many years that I didn't want anybody infringing on my in my space, so to speak. And she finally chipped away at the wall to where the wall fell down, and of course we became one. But in the process, I don't know what happened to our families. Of course, about that time that we got married, I had all kinds of things going on in my life. I had the happiness of planning the wedding. We had the happiness of planning the wedding and going to Florida and getting married. And at the same time, I was dealing with my brother. My brother was dying, and it was hard to keep that. And high and low was unbelievable. It was really tough. And then of course when we came back from the wedding, the following week we had a sort of a get together for family and friends that couldn't make it to Florida because I didn't expect anybody to go down there. Too expensive to travel down there for a 5-minute wedding, I didn't expect that. So we did have a couple of Debbie's aunts come down. But came back, and then, of course, the following week, my brother died. And then at the same time, I left the IRS, and I got tired of that. So back to the family part. My sister, I have two sisters left. One lives in Chicago, and one lives 5 miles from me. The one who lives 5 miles from me hadn't spoke to me over 2 years. She got mad she got mad. I think it was in the spring. I saw her. No, it wasn't spring. I don't know when it was. Summer or something. She said something about Thanksgiving. And I thought, what the? We're talking about Thanksgiving now for it. It was June or July or something like that. And she said, you and Debbie come to Thanksgiving. And I said, well, yeah, maybe. I mean, I didn't know what our plans were. It was our first year together. So, you know, most of you women know, the woman makes the decision on where to go. It didn't matter to me. I didn't really care. But Debbie wanted to go to her dance. So we went. And my sister got mad. And she hadn't spoke to me since. And but yet I hear through the grapevine, every time she has a grill out, or my brother's daughter has a grill out, or cookout, or Christmas, or Thanksgiving, or whatever they have down their house, they invite my ex. And of course, you all realize my ex raises my grandson, and God bless her for doing that. I'm thrilled to death that she's able to do it, because he's a good kid. Probably a lot better off with her than he would be with my daughter, I can tell you that. Which, she's another story. Sometime I'll get into her. She hasn't spoke to me either. So, that must be a hard ass to get along with. I'm not really, I'm just... I don't know what happened to him. But anyway, my ex shows up at all my family's functions. Well, on the other side of the coin, we got Debbie and her ex. Okay, granted, she was married, I don't know, she's married 20-something years, too. But, lo and behold, all her family functions. Guess who's there? The ex. We never get invited. Her sister has Christmas, her sister has Thanksgiving now. Her sister has grill outs during the summer. They have family reunions over in Indiana. And guess who shows up? The ex is invited. And so Debbie and I are there, we sit at home. So, you know, I don't understand it. I don't know if any of you got families like that, that they're screwed up, in my opinion. I mean, there's nothing wrong with getting along with the ex. I mean, you know, I don't care that my niece calls my ex-wife. My brother's wife and my ex-wife grew up together, and they went all through school together, and they wound up marrying brothers. I got nothing against that. And Angie was really close to my ex, and I have nothing at all against that. But the thing is, I think she should either go visit her, she should call her and have her come out, and they should go do lunch or whatever. And but I don't think they should be involved in my new life, and I don't think Debbie's ex should be involved in her new life. It's really made a problem. It really has. And it just creates a lot of problems, and we're almost up to 9 minutes, so I'm going to cut this, and then I'll start a new one and finish it. So I'll be right back.